And suppose there are set of transactions happening into the system, wherein each transaction is waiting for some another transaction to release the lock. It means that suppose transaction T1 is there and T2 is there. T1 is waiting for transaction T2 to hold the lock on the data item which is held by transaction T2 and which is required by transaction T1. Similarly, transaction T1 holds a data item which is required by transaction T2, and in the process T2 wants that data item from T1, so it send a request for a lock, and both don't want to release it because they are working on it. They are not in a position to release the lock till one of them releases the lock, right? So they are mutually dependent on each other and nobody is releasing the lock. So this situation is considered as deadlock. So deadlock is a condition where two or more transactions are waiting indefinitely for one another to give up the locks. Deadlock is said to be one of the most feared complications in DBMS softwares, as no task ever gets completed or finished and is in a waiting state forever if it is not resolved. For example, consider that there are two tables, student and grade. There are two tables, student and grade, and there are two transactions, T1 and T2. You can see this particular diagram also. There are two transactions, T1 and T2. T1 holds a lock on some rows and needs to update some rows in the grade table. So T1 is holding the lock on students' records, few records of the students, and it wants the lock on some records in a grade table. Similarly, at the same time, transaction T2 holds locks on some rows in the grade table, but it requires a lock on student records, which is held by T1. Now the main problem arises. T1 is waiting for T2 to release the lock. Similarly, T2 is waiting for T1 to release the lock. All activities comes to a halt state and remain at a standstill. It will remain in standstill until the DBMS detect a deadlock and abort one of the transactions out of these two. So to avoid this deadlock, any one transaction has to be rolled back. Then which transaction has to be rolled back? It is decided by DBMS by using the methodology of detection and prevention. Okay. One of the transaction gets killed and the other transaction is allowed to execute by the DBMS software. So this diagram depicts the condition of deadlock. Okay. Now another point is that how we can avoid the deadlock in the system. There are two ways we can do the deadlock handling, that is deadlock avoidance and deadlock detection. When in deadlock avoidance, when a database is stuck in a deadlock state, then it is better to avoid the database rather than aborting and restarting the database. This is wastage of time and resources. It means that if it is better to avoid that deadlock rather than aborting or restarting the entire thing of the database, it will always take a lot of time and the resources to do that action. In deadlock avoidance mechanism, we are going to use one graph that is called as wait for graph. A method like wait for graph is used for detecting the deadlock situation. But this method is suitable only for smaller databases and it does not work for larger databases. For larger databases, we have to use another method of handling of database, database deadlock, that is called as deadlock prevention method. Now, how to detect a deadlock in the system? In a database, a transaction waits indefinitely to obtain a log. Then the DBMS detect whether the transaction is involved in a deadlock or not. The log manager maintains a wait for graph to detect the deadlock cycle in the database. Whenever you draw a wait for graph, you always represent every transaction by the vertex like this, T1 and T2 in this graph. So T1 is requesting a lock on resource R2, which is held by T2, and say T2 wants a lock on resource R1, which is held by transaction T1. And suppose in your wait for graph, there is a cycle. If there is a cycle in the wait for graph, then we can say that there is a deadlock in the system. Wait for graph is suitable method for deadlock detection. In this method, a graph is created based on the transaction and their locks. If the graph created graph has a cycle or closed loop, then there is a deadlock in the system. The wait for graph is maintained by the system for every transaction which is waiting for some data held by some other transaction. The system keeps checking the graph if there is any cycle in the graph. Like this, if there is any cycle, then we can say that there is a deadlock. It means that DBMS system has to decide which transaction has to be rolled back to avoid this deadlock, right? So there are methods of prevention by which we can cancel one of the transaction, we allow another transaction to execute, and we solve the deadlock. Okay. So in deadlock prevention scheme, we can work on large databases. Okay. Deadlock prevention method is suitable for large databases if resources are allocated in such a way that deadlock never occurs. Then the deadlock can be prevented. The database management system analyzes the operations of the transaction, whether they can create a deadlock situation or not. If they do, then DBMS never allows the transaction to be executed. It is decided which transaction has to be rolled back and which transaction has to be allowed to complete it. And there are two methods in deadlock prevention called as wait die scheme and wound wait scheme. So there are only two possibilities. A transaction is older or a transaction is younger. So in one method, it allows the older transaction to execute, whereas in another method, it allows younger transaction to execute. Okay, so let us see now. Wait die scheme of deadlock prevention. In wait die scheme, if a transaction requests for a resource which is already held with a conflicting lock by another transaction, then the DBMS simply checks the timestamp of both the transactions. It allows the older transaction to wait until the resource is available for execution. So this method allows the older transaction to execute. It does not kill older transaction. Right? It kills younger transaction. It allows older transaction to execute. We already studied what is timestamp is in the last lecture. Okay, let us assume that there are two transactions, TI and TJ, and TS of T is the timestamp of any transaction, T. If T2 holds a lock by some other transaction and T1 is requesting for resources held by T2, then the following action has to be performed by the DBMS software. First of all, it checks, DBMS software checks, if timestamp of the transaction TI is less than timestamp of transaction TJ, it means that in this case, transaction TI gets started first and later on transaction TJ started. If TI is the older transaction here and TJ has held some resource, then TI is allowed to wait until the data item is available for the execution. That means if the older transaction is waiting for a resource which is logged by the younger transaction, then the older transaction is allowed to wait for the resource until it is available. So here always older transaction is allowed to wait for its execution. Second thing is, again it checks if timestamp of TI is less than timestamp of TJ. If TI is an older transaction and has held some resource, and if TJ is waiting for it, then in this case, the younger transaction TJ is killed and it is restarted later with the random delay, but with the same time, with the same timestamp. So in short, we need to remember that in case of wait die skip, according to the timestamp, a transaction we started earlier is allowed to wait, it allowed to execute, and younger transaction is killed to solve the delay. Now the next scheme is wound wait scheme. In wound wait scheme, if the older transaction requests for a resource which is held by younger transaction, then the older transaction forces the younger transaction to kill the transaction and release the resource. After a minute delay, the younger transaction is again restarted, but with the same timestamp. If the older transaction has held a resource which is requested by the younger transaction, then younger transaction is asked to wait until the older transaction releases it. So it means that in wound wait scheme, the younger transaction is allowed to wait, but not killed by the system, right? So, but there is a sequence. It allows older transaction to execute. Once it releases the lock, which is held by on a data item by the older transaction, and which is required by younger transaction. After that, it allows younger transaction to execute on the system. So there are two things here, that is wound wait scheme and wait die scheme. In the first case, it won't allow the younger transaction to execute. It killed it and it restarted it. And it restarted with a random delay with the same timestamp. Here it is again killed, but it allows the transaction to start in a minute with the same timestamp. Okay, so